Good morning, children. Today we are doing a poem, A Fine Day, page number 105, Raindrops. The poet of this poem is Catherine Mansfield. Children, you must have seen when the rain is there, after the rain, the water is in our surrounding and mud is there. And pools of water are also there, and it becomes messy sometimes. And after the rain, we expect for the sun. These feelings also have been described in this poem. After all the rain, the sun shines on hill and grassy mead. Grassy mead means the grassy fields where the grass is grown and it is used by the animals for grazing. Fly into the garden, child, you are very glad indeed. And the poet says, child, you fly into the garden. Fly into the garden means you go and play, run, whatever you want to do, you do in the garden. Because the child is very happy after the rain, when the sun is shining. For the day, you go on, beta, underline, circling these words. These are rhyming words. For the days have been so dull, oh so special, dark and dreary. Before the rain, it becomes cloudy and the days become dull. That you told me, Mr. Sun has forgotten, we live here. And the child is saying, he told me, Mr. Sun has forgotten, that we live here, means when the rain is there, the sun was not shining. So he says, the sun has forgotten us. On the lilac tree, a bird singing first a little more note, then a burst of happy song bubbles in his lifted throat. On the lilac tree means this is a flowering tree in Europe and North America. On this tree, special tree, a bird is singing a little note. Little note means little bit he is singing, and gradually his singing burst into a happy song and bubbles in his lifted throat, and those words of the song were in his throat. Oh, the sun, the comfy sun, this the song that you must sing. Thank you for the birds, the flowers, thank you sun for everything. Now the poet and the child are saying, oh sun, you are a comfortable sun. When you are there, we feel comfortable. This the song that you must sing, and this is the song that you must sing. The birds and the children should sing a song when they are happy. Thank you for the birds, the flowers, thank you sun for everything. The child says he is thankful to the sun, for the birds, for the flowers, for everything that are coming out after the rain and when the sun shines. Now children, you have to see the meanings of these words in the poem, and you learn them also, because some words are having special meanings in the poems. Now let's do the exercise. The poem has four verses. Match the pictures to the verses. Write first, second, third or fourth. Now we see in the poem, first it was described the weather was cloudy. So you write first over here. And the second is it rains after the clouds. And the third is after the rain, the sun shines. And the fourth one is when the sun shines, the child goes to play. So you write here first in first, and then third, then second, and then fourth. Now we have to do exercise C first. When the speaker in the poem says, "Fly into the garden, child," she is asking the child to run out into the garden. Now take the words that mean the same as run. You may use a dictionary. If you see, then we will find you can take race, amble, jog, wander, trudge, stroll, and trot. These three words do not match with the word run. Now D exercise. In the poem, the word comfy has been used to mean comfortable. Match these informal words to their formal meanings. In the on mobiles also, you most of the time when you do chatting, you use abbreviations or some words of your convenience. So here are, we have some words we will be matching with the words that are having formal meanings. First is roomie. He is my roomie. Roomie means roommate. So you put one over here. And goalie. Goalie means the goalkeeper. Third is hanky. Most of the time you use this word. This is handkerchief. Pics. This is pictures. You use this word also most of the time. Newbie means newcomer. You can see the showroom written over there. Newbies. Newbies means newcomer. Means newborn babies. Cabbie. Cabbie means cab driver. So you can learn these also. And you can learn the formal meanings of these informal words also. Now children, we will be doing exercise B. Find a poem, Raindrops, page 105. Answer these questions. Why are the speaker and the child so happy? As in the poem we have read, so we will start the answer from the question. The speaker and the child are so happy because the sun shines on the hill and the grassy mat. Where is the speaker asking the child to go? The speaker is asking the child to go to the garden. Now third one is, what made the child think that the sun had forgotten that they lived there? So we have read in the, we have seen in the poem, ki rain made the child think that the sun had forgotten that they lived there. Whom does is refer to in this line? Bubbles in his lifted throat. So we have seen the birds were there in the trees and they were singing. So we can say his refers to a bird in the line, bubbles in his lifted throat. What is the speaker asking the child to thank the sun for? So start from the question also. The speaker is asking the child to thank the sun for the birds, for the flowers, and for everything. Now children, you do fair all these questions in your fair notebook and fill the exercises in your book and read the poem again and recite the poem also, and you do the exercises and you read next chapter. Poe. We will be doing the next chapter. Poe. Very good chapter. And next class, we will be doing this chapter, Poe, chapter 9. And you read it in advance at your home. Thank you all.